guys, you ready?
Yes, sir.
The rules of the road, like we always talk about ahead of time. We are going to give you, when I say we have a representative from the FBI, from the Secret Service, from the State Attorney's Office. We're going to give you everything we have. Everything. All right? So when we get done, think about your questions, because we're not going to take a lot. And keep them to the information that you heard. Don't get into what ifs, and because of this, we're not going to go there. All right? So keep that in mind, and we'll be good. So here we go. All right. 1:30 this afternoon, a call came out, shots fired. That was called in by the Secret Service. Because we're in constant contact with them all the time, we were notified of that, and we had units here that immediately sealed off the area. Fortunately, we were able to locate a witness that came to us and said, hey, I saw the guy running out of the bushes. He jumped into a black Nissan, and I took a picture of the vehicle and the tag, which was great. So we had that information. Our real-time crime center put it out to the license plate readers. And we were able to get a hit on that vehicle on I-95 as it was headed into Martin County. We got a hold of Martin County Sheriff's Office, alerted them, and they spotted the vehicle and pulled it over and detained the guy. After that, we took the victim, the witness to the incident, took him up there, and he identified as the person that he saw running out of the bushes and jumped into his car. Now, in the bushes where this guy was, is an AK-47 style rifle with a scope, two backpacks which were hung on the fence that had a ceramic tile in them, and a GoPro, which he was going to take pictures of. So those are being processed right now. The Secret Service agent that was on the course did a fantastic job. What they do is they have an agent that jumps one hole ahead of time to where the president was at. And he was able to spot this rifle barrel sticking out of the fence and immediately engage that individual, at which time the individual took off. So that's what we know about the investigation. We have somebody in custody right now that is a potential suspect. We've got a little bit more work to do on it. But as we usually do, as soon as we decide that we're going to book him into the county jail and the charges that he's going to be booked into, we'll get those to you and we'll get a picture of him and we'll get you his background. So now I'm going to turn it over to the representative of the Secret Service and he's going to make a brief statement.
Hi, good afternoon, everyone. I first want to thank all of our law enforcement partners, to include the Palm Beach Sheriff's Office and Martin Sheriff's Office for their involvement today. Former President Donald Trump is safe and unharmed following a protective incident shortly before 2 p.m. on Sunday at Trump International Golf Club at West Palm Beach. The U.S. Secret Service personnel opened fire on a gunman located near the property line, and this matter is under investigation. I'll turn it over to my partners over at the
Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Jeffrey Beltre. I'm a special agent in charge of the FBI's Miami Field Office. The FBI has assumed the role as the lead federal law enforcement agency in the investigation of the incident that occurred earlier today at Trump International Golf Course here in West Palm Beach, Florida. We've deployed a number of resources, including investigative teams, crisis response team members, bomb technicians, evidence response team members as well. What we need right now is for the public to avoid the area around the golf course. We will continue to support this investigation with the full resources of the FBI. Alongside our partners with the United States Secret Service and the Palm Beach Sheriff's Office, as well as the Martin County Sheriff's Office, and state and local law enforcement. I would ask that if anyone has any information that may assist with this investigation, to contact our tip line, 1-800-CALL-FBI, or at tips, that's T-I-P-S, .FBI.gov. Thank you.
I am Dave Narenker, State Attorney for Palm Beach County. I want to thank Sheriff Bradshaw and our partner.
partners at the local, state, and federal levels. I'm here because our prosecutors are currently working up warrants and a motion for pretrial detention for the suspect. In that way, he will be kept in custody. But our filing of these warrants and charges at the state level does not preclude federal charges that could be coming. But in the meantime, it looks like the warrants and the pretrial detention motion will happen first. And again, I want to thank the cooperation we've had with our federal partners and at the local level. And thank you all for being here.
Okay, we're going to make these pictures available to you. It'll show you a picture of the backpack and the rifle. And there's also a GoPro on the fence there where it was intent on filming what was going on. Even though we're going to have to secure a couple areas around the golf course here, the public doesn't need to panic. We know that we got a post office, a library, and a school down the street. So we'll make it convenient for you to get to all the places you need to go, get the kids to school, get them over here to the post office, or wherever else you need to go. It's safe. There's no more danger here, and we'll make it very convenient for you. So having said that, we're going to take a very limited amount of questions, and you can direct them to who you want to answer the question.
Sheriff, did this individual make any statements as he was being detained?
No statement right now as far as his involvement in the incident, and there's further investigation to be completed.
What was his demeanor like?
Yeah, I'm not sure if maybe it was the first gentleman answered. I misunderstood, or I couldn't understand. So there was a rifle. So one of your agents saw on the golf course saw a rifle pointing to a fence with a chain link. Okay, so he saw that, the agent?
That is correct, yes.
And the president or former president was on the course behind him. How close?
It was one or two holes behind.
100%.
Because the bubble beam was through the golf course. So our agents will get there first, clear it. You notice that the rifle was pointed out, our agents engaged. We are not sure right now if the individual is able to take a shot at our agents, but for sure our agents were able to engage with him.
Was he hit?
I don't
know.
Is there
a moment? How far away was the president? How far away was Donald Trump when this gentleman was caught and stopped?
Probably between 300 and 500 yards. But with a rifle and a scope like that, that's not a long distance.
For the Secret Service, how far was your agent from the would-be assailant?
I'm not sure. No, that's wishful
thinking. Reports of the four rounds of ammunition were fired. Were all four of them from your agent?
That is correct. 4-6, we're not sure.
Was there a long distance? Explain your logic.
Yes.
Thank you. And then I met WPBF 25. I was wondering what the how this was able to happen, and for future reference, is there any up security in the golf course?
Say that one more time and talk up a little bit.
So how was this able to happen, and for future reference, is there any up security in the golf course?
Well, you gotta understand, the golf course is surrounded by shrubbery. So when somebody gets into the shrubbery, they're pretty much out of sight, right? And at this level that he is at right now, he's not the sitting president. If he was, we would have had this iron golf course around him. Well, because he's not, security is limited to the area that the Secret Service deems possible. So I would imagine that the next time he comes to the golf course, there'll probably be a little more people around the perimeter, but the Secret Service did exactly what they should have done. They provided exactly what the protection should have been, and their agents did a fantastic job.
Which direction was the shrubbery? Where he was? North, south? I guess east, west, and south is the road?
The layout of the golf course, you've got three holes, 5, 6, and 7, right? One of them runs parallel to Summit Boulevard, one of them runs parallel to Congress. And he was in an area in the shrubbery where he could see both holes. So the president was on another hole back, which means he's about between 400 and 500 yards away.
So he was on the golf course?
Oh, he's on the golf course, yeah, but he's back away.
For the Secret Service, have you guys changed at all the way that you guys are protecting former President Donald Trump? This now potential second attack on him? Can you just elaborate on how things have changed and what you made of all this?
Yes, the threat level is high.
have increased the amount of assets that we supported, so we are living in danger time, so yes.
We're done with questions right now. We went to the Forbes for us to add. Just want to tell you, the Secret Service and the FBI and the State Attorney's Office have been fantastic to work with. And I can tell you right now, our agency with this real-time crime center was fabulous. That's how we got there. We started out with, we don't know anything, to where we had a tag, we had a vehicle description, and we got an area where we saw the person.
How many
so
minutes?
Be proud of your law enforcement. All right. Thanks, folks.
We'll be back to you.